Hello everyone. The first episode of my Q&A video got so many people saying how much they loved it, and everyone was sending me really good comments, and it made me more confident to like post the next video. So thank you guys, and let's get on with the ask. What is a fandom or franchise that I thought was cool but never got invested in? Marble Hornets. I love scary stuff. I love found footage type horror series and all that. A lot of the audio in episodes was really hard to understand, especially because I have audio processing issues, and that's probably the reason why I couldn't get into it as much as I wanted to. If I could pet one dinosaur from Jurassic Park without dying, which one would I pick? If you have met me for 2 seconds or longer, you would know that it would be the Velociraptor. I've always loved Velociraptors. They're my favorite dinosaur ever, and I love the Jurassic Park 3 Velociraptors the most. In my opinion, what's the scariest SCP and which one's my favorite? In my opinion, the scariest SCP is SCP-096, aka Shy Guy, and SCP-682, aka Invincible Lizard. They're both terrifying, and if you get them angry, we're all fucked. My favorite SCP is SCP-999, because it's a serotonin goo and it cures depression, and I just want one in my life. What are some obscure shows, games, and comics that I would recommend to others to check out? Ones that are not talked about or well known. For games, I recommend Cattails. It's a really nice and soft game about basically you go around being a cat, and it's just a really fun game. Comics, I recommend Moonstruck, which is an LGBT comic about a werewolf and her girlfriend, and there's a gender fluid centaur and a bunch of other really cool characters. I also recommend Skybox, which is, I can link it in the description below, because it's a really good webcomic that I've been following for a few years now, and I love it. Foot Rot Flats, which is more adult-oriented, so not really for younger audiences, but it's a really good New Zealand comic that I recommend. Books, Animorphs, the books with the people turning into animals, looks a bit creepy. The books are pretty violent though, but they're amazing and the characters are pretty good. Shows, I recommend Zoo, which is about a show about animals rising up and taking over the world and attacking people. It's really good. Season 3 sucks though, just watch season 1 and 2. And Heroes, which is a series about superpowered human beings trying to stop the end of the world, which is a really good show, but there's heaps of seasons, but season 1 and 2 are the only good seasons in my opinion. Don't watch anything else after that. In the description, I'll write a bit about each of the things I talked about so people can check them out if they want to. I'll also add a few others in the description as well that I didn't mention here. What's the most interesting theory about a franchise you've heard? Okay, so not to talk about Good Omens, but my favorite theory is that the Antichrist is only powerful because the angels and demons actually think he is. So in the show, it mentions that a lot of the things, like a lot of the stuff that angels and demons do are based on what they believe. So they're like limited by their imagination. It's even canon in episode 5. What if like the Antichrist, Adam, is only powerful because the angels and demons believe him to be? And I think that's just a really interesting theory to me, and I think it just sounds super funny. Like, the Antichrist is just so powerful because all these angels and demons all believe he is. She asks 2 questions, so I decide to put them into 1 question. Which stage of drawing do I enjoy most? And when I started drawing, what was the area that I excelled at most? I enjoyed doing the line art a lot. It's just really nice, and I like it when the lines are nice and smooth. It depends when it comes to when I started, when I was really young, or when it was 2012 when I actually started focusing on art. I think it's the same as now, so I definitely did well at my line art as I do now, and that's just one thing that I've just always excelled at. Ah, hello Mel! No, I haven't answered this. Go on a rant, a tangent about my favorite cat breed and which characters I've designed with said cat breed. I have three main cat breeds that I love. I have Oriental short slash long hair, Turkish Angora, and Abyssinian slash Somali. My favorite Orientals are Papyrus from Undertale and Soundwave and Starscream from Transformers Prime. My favorite Angora cats are Joker from Batman and Lucifer from Lucifer. Abyssinian slash Somalis are Crowley from Good Omens and Captain America, who I made a blue Abyssinian. I love Orientals. They're basically gremlins with giant ears. Did you know there are two different types of Orientals, American and European Oriental? You can tell the difference between by their ears. Angoras have just the fluffiest fur. I really just want to hold them forever. And Abyssinian slash Somali have the best pattern. What social stigma does society need to get over? That LGBT community are inherently sexual or not appropriate for kids. People with DID or schizophrenia are more dangerous. That vaccines cause autism, because they really don't. And the amount of ableism and homophobia and all that is just disgusting, and it really needs to stop. Off topic, but still similar to ableism, triggered needs to stop being used as a joke, because it's never funny, it never will be. Because it's incredibly ableist and it mocks people who do go into panic attacks due to triggers. Triggered does not mean angry or upset or sad. It means a certain thing, like a movie, song, person, or place that reminds someone of something that happened in their past that traumatized them. So everything they hear or see of that certain thing they're reminded of that sends them into a panic attack, if that makes sense. Just stop using triggered as a joke. It's not funny, it's stupid, and it's really ableist. What is my favorite fandom that I'm in, and what are some food combinations that I enjoy? My fandoms change very often, depends what I hyperfixate on at the moment. So right now it's Good Omens, especially because a lot of the fandom, not all of it, a lot of the fandom very open, and I've been seeing so many LGBT positive things, especially with non-binary and trans headcanons. I mean, the fandom's not perfect, there are still the assholes, but all fandoms have that. Weird food combinations that I enjoy. I'm very hypersensitive to specific foods and textures, so that's a very rare thing for me to enjoy weird foods. But weird foods that I actually do like, I like peanut butter and honey together, like in a sandwich. I like Vegemite butter and cheese together, and I like pasta and broccoli because it's actually really nice. Do I love you? I don't know, Anon, I don't know who you are. If this is Cloud, then yes. If this is somebody else, like a mutual or friend, I love you as a friend, sure, why not? But I have no idea who you are. You're on Anon. So you got to be more specific about that. How did I find out I was a kinny? Also, hi. Well, guys, I'm outed as a kinny. Best to go jump out the window now. I just saw a character, my first kin, Eddie Brock, and said, hey, that's me. And that's it. That's how I became a kinny. Whoops. Who's my favorite Marvel character? Depends. MCU or in general? My favorite general character is Eddie Brock, obviously, but I also love Flash Thompson and Deadpool. MCU character is Spider-Man. What programs do I use for drawing and video editing and stuff? For drawing, I do Fire Alpaca for map parts, and I mainly use Medibang Paint Pro just to draw in general stuff. Video editing, I use either Movie Maker or Sony Vegas Pro. Sony Vegas Pro is for my maps, and Movie Maker is for anything else. This series that I'm doing was originally on Movie Maker, but then I decided to start using Vegas Pro. How do I feel about Iron Dad and Spider Son? Absolutely amazing. I adore it so much. I just need more content of just Iron Man being a dad. Especially in the terms of trans Spider-Man and Iron Man just being an amazing father figure slash I'm gonna freaking destroy any transphobe who says shit about my son. However, if anybody decides to ship them, I fucking delete them because they're all disgusting. What's my opinion on Venom 2018? Should the critics be so harsh on it? Look, the movie isn't perfect, but it's one of my all-time favorite movies. I've watched it so many times in the past year, I just absolutely freaking love it. It's stupid, it's crazy, and I absolutely adore everything about it. I think the critics are too harsh, especially because a lot of the audience actually really does like the movie. I mean, the plot's eh. I really don't want that to, I don't want them to take the same route that they did with the first movie with the way they did the plot, and I definitely don't want there to be any romance in the second movie. Okay, that's a lie. I want Eddie and Venom to be together because they're actually canon in the comics. But the movie is amazing. It's one of my all-time favorites, and sometimes it is my favorite. It's amazing, and it deserves more love, but I don't think it should be like it is in the second movie. Any tips on how to get a big, decent following as an artist? I'm not sure if I have the authority to say this, because I am not really that popular. I have maybe 400 followers on YouTube, and around 600 on Tumblr, but even then, I'm like not that popular compared to a lot of other artists. I don't get a lot of attention on any of my art. I guess if you want to get more attention, you can tag your posts, share them around with friends and like get them to reblog it and reshare them. Tagging is always good. Joining communities and making friends through that has helped my art a lot this year. So having lots and lots of friends in different places is a good idea to get your art around so other people can see them. How many cats have I had in the past? All my life I've had cats. So the first cat I ever had was Sparky, who I had until 2008 when she passed away. Then I didn't have any other cats until 2010 when I got G. And I had her for 2 years until 2012. And then I didn't have another cat until I got Sanchez, which is who I got in 2013, who I had for about a year. And then I got Heidi in 2014, and I still have Heidi. In 2015, we got Mituna, who was with us for only a few months and passed away in 2016. Heidi was really sad then, and we didn't get another cat until last year in 2018, and we got Sheba, who's still with us now. So Heidi and Sheba at the moment, who somewhat get along, but they still fight. They're both adorable though. What are some of my LGBT headcanons for Marvel characters? My LGBT headcanons for Marvel characters. I have quite a lot of them for a lot of characters, so I'm just gonna say some of my main ones. I headcanon Eddie Brock as trans bi, though in the comics he is canonically bi with being with Venom. I headcanon Venom as ace and agender, which are both basically canon. Flash Thompson, from the comics at least, bi. I headcanon Peter Parker as trans and bi, as well as Tony Stark, who I also headcanon as bi. Miles Morales is trans. Carol is bi. Thor is also bi. Loki I headcanon as pan gender fluid. Sam Wilson is trans. Natasha is ace arrow. And Bruce is pan. What are some of my favorite horror movies? I don't really watch a lot of horror movies. I prefer horror games a bit more. They're just scarier and more interesting to me. But I do like a few horror movies. I really like Get Out, The Ring, which is another good one. I like Zombieland, Dawn of the Dead, and World War Z. I really need to read the book because I heard that's like so much better than the movie. I also like The Shining and Alien. I also really like the Saw movies, even though I've only seen 2.5 of them, the second one being my favorite. But that's about it, really. Do I prefer jumpy or blood and gore horror movies? Who's my favorite horror movie villain, and is there any horror characters that scare me? I prefer psychological horror, actually. But if I had to choose between the two, I think I like gore and violence a lot more. Horror movie villain? Villain. I like the villains that are like seeming unstoppable. So I really like Alien from the Alien movies because it's just so freaking scary, you can't reason with it or talk to it. You don't know what it wants. It's just a living creature that it only wants blood, and that's just the scary ones to me, honestly. And horror characters that scare me, Eddie Gluskin from the game Outlast Whistleblower. He is absolutely freaking terrifying with some of the things that he does and says about you and other people in the game. It is really scary and what he plans to do. He's absolutely freaking terrifying, and I hate him, but I also love him because his story is really good. And to be honest, I literally paused from playing the game for months just because I was too scared to play against him. Yeah. What's my favorite horror game and what are my favorite horror game characters? My favorite horror games are Outlast and Outlast Whistleblower, which I don't like the second game, by the way, and I like Franbo. And my favorite horror game video game characters, Eddie Gluskin from Outlast Whistleblower, Richard Traeger from Outlast, and Mr. Midnight from Franbo. Actually, with the last few horror asks, I'm going to say that my next video will be horror themed, with Halloween coming up. So all asks from now on, I recommend, well, you don't have to if you don't want to, but I want to have a horror themed ask Q&A video for next time. So thank you all for watching. See ya.